So we are going to learn today the trees. So we have already started some part of the trees already. That we have covered in the heap. So we are going to learn the tree traversal today. First we are going to discuss about some part of the binary trees, and after that we'll be discussing the tree traversal. Okay, because we have already used some tree traversal in the case of heap when we were doing the linked list representation of the heap data structure. Okay, so can somebody tell why we are using tree data structure? Why array or linear data structures are not enough? Means what are the major use of tree data structure? Means is there any advantage of tree data structure? Okay, better complexity. Good, better complexity. Yes, in the case of BHT, if I want to search some data, I can do it in better complexity than in the linear data structures. Yes, any other thing? Okay, there are some data means present in our computer that are already in the hierarchy form. So storing the data in the data is already in hierarchy form. Storing the data into the tree structure will be very easy for us, and will be very easy to understand for ourselves. Okay. So what I'm going to design today. So first I'm going to design a binary tree. What are binary trees? Binary tree can have maximum two children. Means it can be 0, 1, or 2. Means every node can have the maximum two children. Let's say the data is here. So we are not talking about the heap or BHT today. So the data at the node can be anything. So let's say the 10 is here, the 20 is here. So we are talking about the general trees. Okay, let's say 30 is being present here, 40, 50. So at this point, we have already talked in the case of heap. So if I want to add some data, add some node, I was adding at the very leftmost vacant place. So I'll be adding here. But in case of if we're talking about general tree, data can be added here as well. Means it can be added at any place. Does not means if we are talking about the general trees, we don't have any foundation, so that means we are bounded to add here data only. So we can add data at the any place or any type of data. Means okay, let's say the 30 is being present here. So now what we are going to do today, we are going to discuss about the tree traversal. So there are two type of tree traversals are there. The first one is BFS. BFS, and the second one is DFS. Depth first search and breadth first search. Okay. What a depth first search is, first we are going to talk about the DFS part. What a DFS part is, DFS part says us first go down and down and down, first explore these nodes, then come up and up and up. And what BFS says, first means breadth first search means go means from up to down. First discover all the nodes that are present at this level, then go to down level, then go to down level. Okay. So in the DFS part, there are three algorithms. What we do in the case of DFS, we do pre-order, post-order, and in-order. I hope most of you have heard about it already. So first we are going to discuss about these concepts, means these algorithms, what these algorithms are. So first we are going to talk about the pre-order traversal. Okay. What I'm going to do, I'm going to talk about the pre-order traversal. So there are pre-order, that is pre, let's say PR. There is post order, that is PS, let's say PS. and there is one more in order, that is IN. Let's see, these are the short name of the tree traversals. Okay, so what we are going to do, every node has all means, if we are talking about our nodes in the tree, every node has either the root node. Let's say I'm calling my root node as N. Okay, and I'm calling my left node as L or the right node as R. Okay, so the basic structure of every node is the same, means it is having one node and it is having the address of a left node as well as the address of a right node. Although it can be null or right can be null at any position because we are talking about the general tree here. Okay, so what a pre-order traversal says, if we are doing a pre-order traversal in this case, what pre-order says is that first explore our node that is present here. After that, explore that left node. After that, explore the right node. So it is saying first explore me, then explore my left subtree. After that, explore my right subtree. Okay. So what I'm going to do. So let's say my traversal starts from here. So what he's saying that first explore me. So exploring me means printing me. If I'm trying to print that, let's say first I'm going to print 10. Okay. After that, what I'm going to do, he's saying that after that, explore my left subtree. So I'm going to explore the left subtree that is 20. Okay. Is that clear with everyone? What I'm doing? After that, I'm going to explore the right subtree that is 30. Okay. So left. Okay. Let me remove some parts so that to make it easy. But we'll do it after a few times. Okay. So what I'm doing here, is it pre-order? Yes, it's pre-order Ninja. So what I'm doing, so first I'm printing myself, then I'm saying print my left subtree. So my left subtree is 40. So my left subtree is 20 and its data are 20, 50. Okay, and it's having only left subtree that is 60. Okay, so what I'm doing here, so the 10 is means 10 is being printed, and after that he's saying that print my left subtree. So left subtree is already means it's a tree. So we are going to again apply our pre-order traversal here. Okay. So for applying pre-order traversal, what I'm going to do, again, I'm going to apply the same rules. So I'm saying first explore 10 is already being explored. So I'm saying explore 20, then explore 20's left and right. So 40's left is 20's left is having 40 and 20's right is having 50. Okay. Because 40 and 50 is not having any subtree. Let's say if the 50 was having some left subtree, let's say it is 10. So again, the 50 will have the data in its part, it will have the 10 here. Okay. It's not going down. Okay, let's see. So what I'm going to do now, let's say the 10 is not here. Let's remove it. Because there is no space. Let's say 20 is not here. So now what I'm going to do, the 20 is being explored. Now after 20, the 30 will be, that is the right subtree of the 10, that it will be good. It will be explored. So for exploring 30, so what I'm going to do, first I'm going to explore 30, then I'm going to explore 30's left. That is 60. After that 60, I'm going to explore 30's right, but 30's right is null, so we are not going to do anything. Okay. So it will be 60 here. Is that fine now? So our pre-order traversal of this tree will be, it will be 10, 20, 40, 50, 60, and 30. Oh, sorry, 30 and 60. Is it fine? So what I'm doing here, I'm not doing anything. I'm just repeating this this algorithm for every node of the tree. So first 10 will be explored, then the right subtree of that, left subtree of that tree, that node, and after that the right subtree of that node. So first 10 will be explored, then 20. For 20 as well as the same algorithm will be applied. So for 20, the 20 will be printed first. After that, the left part of the 20, that is 40, because 40 is not having any subtree again, so we are not exploring that. If, let's say 40 is having some left tree, so before exploring 50, I'm going to explore that 40 is that subtrees, okay? Because after exploring 20, I'm going to explore 20's left subtree, because if 40 is having some subtrees, that will be the either it will be the subtree of the 40, it will be at the left hand side or right hand side. We are going to it will be in the left part of the 20. Okay, so first we are going to explore that node. Is that fine? Or do anybody is having any problem? If you're not having any problem, so do tell me so that I can code it. Not understood clearly. Okay, so again, what I'm going to do, I'm going to repeat it again in a quick method. Okay, Ninja. So what I'm doing here. So okay, just wait for a minute. Let me erase this first. Okay, just let's understand from this concept, this example only. So this is our tree. It is having 10 as a root, and the 20 and the 30 of the its left and right subtree, and the 20 is left is 40, 20 is right is 50, and 30 is left is 60, and 30 is right is nothing. Let's say it is pointing to a null value. Okay, the 40 is left will also be pointing to null, and 40 is right will also be pointing to null. 50 is left and 50 is right, because if we are not having any data, it means its left and right is pointing to null. Okay, so what I'm doing here, so what our left order traversal says, first explore left hand node means that is first explore me, then explore my right left subtree, after that explore my right subtree. So what I'm doing here, so let's say my traversal start from root 10. So first I'm printing 10, then I'm going to print my left subtree of 10. After that, I'm going to print my right subtree of 10. But before going to right subtree, first I'm going to print my completely left tree, because what it says, algorithm says, first print me, then print my left subtree completely. Okay, so I'm printing 10 here, and again I'm going to 20. So the algorithm applies on the 20s in the same manner. So what the algorithm says, algorithm again says that print 20 first, then print the left subtree, then print the right subtree. So what I'm doing printing left subtree, then I'm printing right subtree. Then I'm printing left subtree, then I'm printing right subtree 50. Okay, that now the complete left part of that root node is printed. So now I'm going to print the right part. In the right part, again the concept will be applied for this root in the same manner. What it will say that print me first, then print my root, then my print my left subtree again, now print my right subtree. So 30 will be printed, and after that the left part of the 30 that will be printed, after that the right part of the 30 will be printed. So 30 is being printed here, 60 is being printed here, and 30's right part is pointing to null, so it is not going to print anything. Okay, so it's a recursive code, means this concept will be applied for all the nodes that is present in the subtree, that is present into our tree. Okay, is it clear to everyone? Means the concept of pre-order traversal. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to print a tree. Okay. Let me open my ID. Okay, so let's create a tree. Can we say that the father of any particular son is also his ancestor? Can we say that father of any particular son, yes, it's also his ancestor? Yes, we can say, Sri, that father of Yes, can be the father of any particular son. Yes, father of any particular son is also his ancestor. Yes, it will be his ancestor. Okay, so what I'm going to do here, let's say I'm creating a node. This node will have, let's create a class instead of structure, although we can use the structure as well. So what I'm going to say, let's say I'm naming my class as tree node. What are the data it will have? It will have a data part, that is int data. Are the three strictly binary, completely tree, and almost complete binary tree are same? Strictly binary tree, complete binary, and almost complete binary tree are the same. Are the strictly binary tree, complete binary tree, and almost binary tree? Okay, Shrey, I'm not clear about it. The strictly binary tree, what you are talking about, but if you want to the solution of this question, I'll send you the solutions. And first I'll see what are the trees are, because I'm not very sure about the strict binary tree. Okay, so what I'm doing here, so I'm first creating the first part, the one part will be the data part, and the and another part will be the left and the right part. Let's see, there will be three data members to our class, left and right, left, right, and the data part. Okay, so what I'm creating here, I'm creating the tree node here. Okay, so let's see. Okay, I'm creating my constructor. So what this constructor will do, this constructor will assign the data to our data part. So what I'm doing, I'm going to use my this pointer, this left. Let's say when we are creating a node, it's left and right we will be pointing to a null. Yes, Smith, you can use parent node, but there is not the use of that parent. If that will be, I mean, a memory consuming part, but you can use that because in the traversal part we don't have that any use of that parent node. Means you are talking about that parent part. Now let's say, because in the case of heap we were having one more part into it, that is parent node, that was having the address of its parent node. But if we are doing the traversal, the normal tree traversals, in that case we don't need that parent node. Okay, that address of that parent node. Okay, if you want you can use that. So this side in the starting it will be pointing to a null value. Okay, so what I'm going to do now, I'm going to create my tree manually, because either you can use heap data structure or BST we'll discuss in the next session. So right now we are going to create our tree, a manual tree. Okay, how a manual tree will look like, let me create it first. So first we'll have a root node. Let's say the tree pointer, and it will be having some value. Let's say tree node, I'm passing my 10 to it. So what this will do, this will create a node, the root will be pointing to that node, and it's into its data part the 10 will be stored, and its left and right will be pointing to a null value. Okay, so now what I'm saying, create into roots left, assign another memory, because roots left is right now pointing to a null value. So what I'm saying, roots left, store in roots left, store 20. Okay, I'm assigning some memory to that address, and I'm saying that store 20 here. Okay, and I'm saying roots right here, I'm creating a normal manual tree. Because today we are concerned about the traversal part only. Okay, so in that part tree is right, because the roots right will be having the data 30, because a node that will be created. So how our structure will look like now. So let's say a node will be created here at 20. Because we are in the main function, we are having only one pointer root from which we can access our tree. Let's say that is root and it is pointing to this node now. So what I'm saying, into trees left, roots left, create another node that is 20. Into roots right, that is another node 30. Okay. So right now we don't know the address of this node, these nodes. It's left and right will be pointing to null. It's left and right will be pointing to null because we are using our constructor of this tree node. Okay. So we don't know the address of node 20, but the 10 in the tens left part, the address of 20 is being stored because tens left is pointing to 20. Let's say if I want to add something here. So I'll be iterating. Let's say I'll be going from my root nodes left because right now I don't know the address of this node. Okay. So we can't directly add its left. So I know the address of my root node. So in that address of my root node is present into this node. So what I'm saying, roots left, in the roots left, at the address of 20 will be stored. And into 20's left, if I want to add some nodes, so I'm going to add something. Okay. So, okay. Let's say what I'm going to do here, roots left, new. The tree node, let's say I'm going to store 40 here. Okay, again roots left right will be also null. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to say that store here 50. Okay, so what I'm doing here in this part, the 40 will be stored, and I'm saying roots left right. So roots left right, that is root, it's left right. In this part, I'm saying store 50. Okay. So now what I'm saying, now roots left is full, roots left right is full. So I'm going to say roots right left because this position will be roots right left and roots right right. Okay. So I'm going to add 60 here and 70 here. Okay. Is that fine? So I'm saying roots right left is equal to new tree node 60. Roots right. Rights is equal to new tree node 70. Okay, so we have already created this the structure of this tree. So if I want to add something, we cannot let's say I want to add something here. It's left part. So how I'm going to add, let's say I want to add 80 here. So how I'm going to add 10's left, that is roots left, right, left. Okay. So what I'm going to do, let's say I'm trying to add 80 here. So what I'm going to say, roots left, right, left. Okay. That is tree node. Let's say add 80 here. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to design my traversal, that is pre-order traversal function. So we have already created this tree. How we are going to check whether we have already created that right tree structure? So if I want to traverse my complete tree, so what I'm going to do, I'm doing statement here, see how pre-order traversal. So I'm going to design a pre-order function. pre-order function, it will be I'll be passing my root to it to this function. Okay. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to design my pre-order function. So let's say the function will not return anything. This will just print the complete data of our tree. So its return type will be void. So pre-order. What I'm saying, I'll be passing my root node to it. So it will be tree node star root. I'm passing my root to it. Okay. So what I'm doing here, I'm saying, because in the root order, in the pre-order, what we have already discussed that in the pre-order, what we do. Okay. So in the pre-order, what we do was first we print the our root node, then we print the left subtree, then we print the right subtree. Okay. So what I'm saying that the root that has came, just print first. So I'm saying print roots data first, then we'll discuss more. Okay. So we have already print its roots data. Now what I'm saying that complete means print its left part. Let's say it's 20. Let's say the 10 is being printed. I'm saying print 10's left completely, 10's left subtree. So what I'm saying, what we have to do, we have to convince in the 20, the same algorithm will be applied. So what I'm saying, let call this function again for roots left. Okay. And after roots left is completed, call roots right. So what I'm going to say, pre-order roots right. Okay. First, I've printed my data, that is roots data. I'm saying do the same operations for the roots left subtree first, then roots right subtree. Okay. So here I'm going to, because it's a recursion function, it will be keep on passing roots left and roots right. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to check whether root exists or not. Because if you're going to, if root does not exist, if you're trying to print roots data, let's say, 40s come here. You are trying to you have passed 40s left. So 40s left will be passed. That will be null. So if roots root is equal to null, so you are not going to do anything. You just return from here. Okay. Is that fine? So what I'm doing here, just I'm saying this: if root is not null, print roots data and call the same function for roots left and roots right. First, I'm going to print it's completely, because when the roots left will be returned, after that roots right will be going to execute. Okay, let's print. Let's see whether we are getting this correct output or not. Okay, we have not printed any space here. I'm saying print and space after printing the data. Okay, the 10. So the 10 is being printed first. After 10. The 20 will be printed, and because its left subtree will be printed. So for 20, the 20 will be printed first, then 20 is left, that is 40. So after 20, the 40 is being printed. After 40, it will come here and its right subtree is going to print it first. So for its right subtree, first the 50 is, let's say right now the 50 is our root node. So the 50 will be printed first, then the 80 will be printed. So the left part is completely over. Now I'm going to print my right subtree. The 30 will be printed first because it's our root node, and its left will be printed after that. After that, its right will be printed. So 10, 20, 40, 80, 50, 60, 30, sorry, 30, 60, and 70. Okay. Is that fine, everyone? Or do anybody is having any problem in that, in the code part? Okay, Ninja is saying no. Okay, I'm assuming that it is clear to everyone. If you are having any doubt, please do let me know. Okay, all clear, Shreya. Okay, so now I'm going to discuss about the post order traversal. Okay, let's see what I'm going to do. I'm going to discuss about the post order traversal. Okay, so let me do it for the same tree. Let me remove some word. Okay. So what I'm going to do for left subtree, first I was printing my root node, that is N. Then I was printing my right to left subtree. After that, I was printing my right subtree. Okay. But in the case of post, let's say I'm discussing about the post order traversal. The post order traversal, first I'm going to print my left subtree completely. Then I'm going to print my right subtree completely. Then I'm going to print about print my root node. So what I'm saying, let's say I'm trying to print my so let's say I'm starting my traversal from this root node. So what I'm saying, print my left subtree completely, then print my right subtree completely, then print me. Okay. So root node, the root node comes at the last. The first comes the left subtree, then right subtree, then the root node. Okay. So how I'm going to print my left subtree? So for the left subtree, again the same rule will be applicable. So what I'm going to do here for the left subtree, I'm going to apply the same rules. For the same rules, again, it will say, the 20 will say, first print my left subtree, then print my right subtree, then print me. So 40, for the 40 as well, 40 will say, first print my left subtree, then right subtree, then print me. Because 40 is left and right does not exist, so I'm going to print my 40 first. Okay. 40 is being present, being printed, it will come to 50 because 20 is left is 40. And the 20 says that print 40 first, then print 50, then print me. So for 50, 50 again say that print first my left subtree and then print my right subtree, then print me. So 50's left and right does not exist, so I'm going to print 50 first. Okay. 20 is left and right subtree over, so I'm going to say that I can print 20 now. Okay. So 10's left subtrees now, fine. So now I'm going to do what I'm going to do. I'm going to print 10's right subtree, that is this tree. So it will come to 30. 30 will again say that print first my left subtree, then my right subtree, then print me. So 30 will go to 60. 60 will again say the same thing because 60 is just not having any side. So it will print 60 first. And after that, 30 what 30 says, print my left subtree first, then right subtree. But in the right part, there is no node present, so I'm not going to print anything. So 60 left and right subtree is over, so I'm going to print 30 now. Okay. Now, our 10's left is completely over, right is completely over. Now I'm going to print my root node, that is 10. Okay. Is that clear with everyone? How our post-order traversal will look like? First 40, 50, 20, 60, 30, and 10. First, the left subtree will be printed, then the right subtree will be printed, then after that, that node, root node will be printed. Okay. Is that clear? I mean, the concept of post order traversal. A bit confusing, but understood. Okay, Ninja, I'm going to explain it again. Don't worry. So, what our post order traversal says, it says that print my left subtree first, then print my right subtree, then print node. So if I'm talking about the subtrees, it means the complete left part and the complete right part. So my I'll call my post order function from this 10 node. So I'm going to say that print from starting root 10 or print all the childs of root 10. Means what traversal means, print all the childs of 10. Okay, that root node. So what this post order traversal says, the algorithm says, it says first print, if the root node is being called, first print its left part, then print its right part, then print me. Okay, so the 10 is being 10 will be called. So first I'm going to print its left child, that is 20, 40, and 50, because its left part will be 20, 40, and 50. First I'm going to finish this, then I'm going to finish this part, then I'm going to print 10. So again for 20, I'm going to the 20 will be in, let's see, because this right subtree's root node is 20. So the same algorithm will be called for this root node 20. So the 20 will say that print first my left part first. So it is saying that print my left part completely first, then print my right part. First print my left part, that is 40. Then print my right part, that is 50. Then print me. So what I'm going to do, because 40 style does not exist, so 40 will not say anything. Either it will say we cannot print its null values. So I'm going to print 40. Then I'm going to print 50, because first I'm going to print its left part, then I'm going to print its right part, then I'm going to print 20. Okay. After that, what I'm doing here, the left part is completely over, because 10 is 10 said that print first print my left part completely, then print my right part completely. So now I'm going to cover the right part. In the right part, the 30 will be the root node of this right subtree. So the algorithm will follow the same rules. So it is going to say that first print the left subtree, then print the right subtree, then print me. So the left subtree, only one data is present, that is 60. So I'm going to print 60. Because in its right part, there is nothing present, so I'm not going to do anything. So after 60, I'll say to 30 that your left and right child is being printed and it is completed. So it is going to say that print me now. Now the right, left and right part of the 10 is being printed, because that is, it was the left and it was the right side. Now it is going to say, the 10 is going to say, if my left and right subtree is being printed, now print me. Okay. So if I'm writing this, it means that print, what you're saying? Yeah, understood. When I try to recall the three traversal, I'm confusing, that's it. You're saying when I try to recall all three traversal, I'm confusing. Okay, you are confusing in order, pre-order and post-order. So in a pre-order means, pre means first means, so the root node will be printed pre in the pre-order, in the first form. And if you're talking about the post-order, the root node will be the printed at the last. But if you're talking about the in-order, if the root node comes first, it will be the pre-order. If root node comes in between, it will be called the in-order. If root node comes at the last, it will be called the post-order traversal. Okay, so now I'm going to talk about the I'm going to implement the post order traversal in the coding part. Let's see what I'm going to see. Let's see how. Design a post order function. Passing the root and I'm changing my line. Okay. So what I'm doing here, so I'm going to design my post order function. So I'll be calling my post order. I'll be calling my root node. So my root node. So again, what I'm going to do, I'll be saying now, first print my left subtree, that is roots left first. Then print my right subtree, that is roots right. If you have completed both the work, then you will be returned. Then print me. See out roots data. And we'll be using our base function in this case as well. The same form, because if root is equal to color, you do not need to do anything. We'll just return for me. Okay. Let's check our post order traversal for the same tree. Okay. Let's quickly design our tree. Our tree was looking like. We design the tree quickly. It was 10, 20, is 30. It is 40. Fifty. 60. 70 and 80 was at which position? Let me check it. It was roots, left, right, left. Okay, 50 is left, was 30. It will be 80 here. Okay, so how our post order traversal will look like? The 10's left part will be printed first, then its right part will be printed, then the root node will be printed. Okay, so again for 20, the same rule will be applied. First print 40, then print the 20's left part is 40, and then print 20's right part. Then for 50, again the same rule will be applied. So the 50 will say first print my left subtree, that is in the left subtree there is only one data, that is 80. Then print my right subtree, 50's right is not, there is nothing, and then print me. Okay, then it will be 50. Again, that the 20's left and right is over, then 20 will say print me now. Now, 10's left is over. So now this function will be called for 10's right. So it's right, again this node will say first print my left subtree, that is 60, then print my right subtree, that is 70, then print me, that is 30. Now 10's left and 10's right is over. Now 10 will say now you can print me. Okay, yes, we can see that we are getting the same output: 40, 80, 50, 20, 60, 70, 30 and 10. Is that clear with everyone? Okay, if you are it is clear. Okay, now I'm going to quickly explain you the in order traversal. I hope now you are clear with the in order traversal. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to talk about the in order traversal. So how our in order traversal will look like? It will be in the in order, the first left subtree will be printed, then the root node will be printed, then the right part will be printed. Okay, the algorithm says L and R, the root node, the left node, then the node, then the right node. Okay, so what we are going to discuss, let's quickly remove it. But our algorithm says first print my left subtree. Again, the 20, 40, and 50 comes the 10th left subtree. And 10th left subtree is so for 20, the same rule will be followed. So 20 will say first print my left subtree, then print me, then print my right subtree. So first 20 will be printed. Sorry. First 40 will be printed because 40 is not having any child. Then 20 will be printed. Then after that 50 is going to print. Okay, for left part it is being over, for left subtree is being over. Now 10 can say, 10 is saying that you can print me now. Okay, now 10 left is over, 10 is also being printed, so it is going to say print, you can print my right subtree now. For the right subtree the same algorithm will be followed. So it will say that you first print my left subtree, then print me, then you print my right subtree. So its left subtree is 60, and this, there is only one data, that is 60. And it's after that, it will be 30 will be printed. Now 30 will say that you can print my right subtree, but 30's right is not, there is nothing in 30's right. So the data will be, the all traversal will be 40, 20, 50, 10, and 60, 30. Okay? Is the concept is clear with everyone? Okay, so now I'm going to quickly design the code for it. Just 1 minute. Okay. Out. In.
order traversal. Design an in order function for it. In order, I'll be passing my root of it. Cout slash n. Let's quickly design my in order function. So again, I'll be having a base case if root is equal to null, do not do anything. And if it is not null, first print my left subtree. Then print me cout data. Then print my right subtree. Okay, let's quickly think. Okay, we have not written the condition for it. Let's read it now. What it is saying, okay. I have to initialize it. Please note that is true. Okay. Okay, Aryan, thank you, Shri. Okay, again, I'm getting that. Okay, one more syntax error is there. Okay, so we are getting our in order tree traversal. Okay, so the 40 is being printed first, the 40, then the. So do I need to design the tree again, or it is clear with you all? So if it is clear, I can move to that BFS part. Okay, Zoom is saying it is clear. If anybody is okay, straight, if it is clear, that's good. So now let's move to our level order traversal. That comes into our BFS part. So by default, in this case, we are using recursion. So by default, recursion use which data structure? Tree, okay, queue or stack? Okay, tracing stack. Yes, so we can say that in order, pre-order and post-order, we are using a stack data structure, okay? So in DFS part, we are using stack, but in BFS, we'll be using our queue data structure,